Matt, you need to wake up right now. Something crazy just happened. The PlayStation 5 logo just got revealed. You still need to do your top 5 hidden gems of 2019. Revan is canon.
I need some type of hype setup because I can't just sit here and talk about Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. I have to be like on my feet, moving around a ton because, God forbid, I just sit still. But you guys know, I've been trying to help lead the charge for the Old Republic to return in Star Wars, make it canon, bring back the games, do new games, do something with this beautiful part of the Star Wars universe. And now, I don't even want to say, is it happening? Will it ever happen? Is it going to happen? It does not matter because I believe it actually is happening, and I have all the proof today alongside a new bit of evidence officially coming from the Visual Dictionary for Star Wars. So ladies and gentlemen, before I get into anything, just know I'm going to be spoiling the hell out of Knights of the Old Republic. I know it's from 2003, a lot of people have already played it, but I still get questions, should I play it? Maddie, I just played it for the first time. In answer to all of you, yes, I have so many videos on this game, please play them. They're available everywhere. PC, backwards compatibility. You can play them on your phones, on your iPads. Play them anywhere and then get back to me. Thank me later, like all these wonderful people around me. All right, so let's start off with, like I said, the latest bit of evidence that proves that Revan is now canon. So alongside the release of Rise of Skywalker, which I have yet to see, by the way, because I'm just totally disinterested in Star Wars as a whole, as it stands when it comes to their movies. But I gotta say, I'm happy it happened because now we have a clear indicator that Revan is canon. So what we're looking at here is a page from the Visual Dictionary, and they're talking about Sith Trooper units and how each of the Sith Trooper units are named after an ancient Sith Lord. And the notable legions mention a bunch of other Sith Lords, but the most notable one for this video here today is the third Sith Legion, which is Revan's Legion. Yes! Now, this isn't actually the first time that modern Star Wars movies have referenced Revan or events surrounding the Old Republic. I think there was one that was a little more niche, if you will. It was an accessory on Luke Skywalker during The Last Jedi. A lot of people pointed it out. It was a little necklace he was wearing. As we can see right here in this picture, we can see that there is a recovered Jedi Crusader pendant around his neck. Now, for those who don't know, the Jedi Crusaders were a faction of Jedi that Revan himself had led against the Mandalorians, so a little nod there. More notably is about Kylo Ren's lightsaber, where they talk about how it has its unusual design and what happened with that, where the crystal originated from, and a Star Wars Visual Dictionary also discussed that Kylo Ren's lightsaber is an unusual design dating back thousands of years to the Great Scourge of Malachor. Now, for those of you who have not played Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 2, this is actually a planet in the game that's very central to the main plot. It's where Revan activated the Mass Shadow Generator, plays a very big part there. And for those who now are staying with us, Revan, of course, is a former Sith who then suffered from amnesia. The Jedi controlled his mind a little bit to erase his memories, make them work for his side. And towards the latter part of the game, the plot flips you on your head and goes, hey, guess what? You're Revan. That person that you've been talking about all game is actually you. I think the plot twist is a little easier to see coming nowadays, but back then it was truly revolutionary, and I remember as a kid my jaw being on the floor, and it's still such a well-told story regardless. But Revan is such a significant piece of Star Wars, of course, and so with all these nods in the Visual Dictionary, it shows that he's officially canon. He is someone that they are going to be working with in the future, and because of that, we jump into our next topic, which is about the reported film. Now, I had talked about this in a previous video. The video didn't do that well performance-wise, so that's why I want to cover it one more time here. For those who aren't aware, Knights of the Old Republic reportedly has a film in the works that's going to be written by Laiita Calligaritis, who did work on Shutter Island, Alita Battle Angel, and Altered Carbon. The last two I know are very good. I've personally seen Alita, and I've heard excellent things about Altered Carbon. So a great writer can potentially helm this film. Naturally, I will say this much, ladies and gentlemen, Revan is such a great character, in my opinion, because we put the identity into him, right? Like, we decide who Revan is at the end of KOTOR 1. And then KOTOR 2, you play as Mitra Surik, who is the Exile. That's her canon name, and we could get into that in another video, but for now we'll focus on Revan. And that's sort of the fun of deciding what he does in the universe, not just from a role-playing game standpoint, but just being able to insert yourself into that character's shoes. And there's definitely been a lot of issues with folks seeing Revan receive a specific identity, we'll put in quotes. Obviously, we know he was once a Sith Lord. That's a part of his lore, but then his future is sort of up to the player, and I always liked that about him as a character. And when you start to see certain depictions of him, like in the Star Wars The Old Republic MMO, which by the way I do like now, I used to not like it, I went back to it once again this past winter and I really enjoyed it. It's still great storytelling. I really recommend it. If you're gonna hop in for the first time, try out the Imperial Operative. Anyway, they did their own depiction of Revan. A lot of people did not like it. I personally understand it, because when you start to round out the character, you start to define him too much. I think that's what starts to hurt him. And obviously, a Old Republic film defining what Revan is, I can't imagine they do an Old Republic film without Revan, really could hurt it. Now, what they could do, in my opinion, is tell the story from Mitra Surik's point of view. I think the story of the Exile would be better told in a show or a movie rather than depicting Revan's journey across the galaxy, getting all the star maps. I don't think it will feature exactly what we saw in Knights of the Old Republic. I think it'll just be a movie set in the Old Republic. But still, when you look at all these bits of evidence, the reports coming in, and then on top of all of that, we have Jedi Knight 2 Jedi Outcast that was announced during a Nintendo Direct last year, and we also know that Jedi Knight Jedi Academy is coming out this year with its multiplayer. We are seeing older Star Wars games make a return, which is super exciting in its own right, of course, but reports, Revan being canon, old Star Wars games coming back, I could totally see Disney at some point announcing, maybe at Star Wars Celebration, a new Knights of the Old Republic movie or a show, maybe for Disney Plus, and then also saying, hey, these Knights of the Old Republic games are also coming back in a package. I could completely see that. They've ported them everywhere. We've seen updates come to KOTOR 2 in the terms of mod support, achievements, support for current resolutions. That game got completely touched up, so the work is done there. All they'd have to do is touch up the original, package them together, and ship them out. So I think a lot of the headway is done here. I think they've been preparing for this for a while. They just wanted to put the right people on the project. Of course, we know way back in the past, BioWare Austin was supposed to work on a KOTOR 1 remake, but that project naturally got put into stasis. I swear, man, like I call it the KOTOR curse. Maybe this is the year it finally goes away, but I always said, man, I victimized myself as a KOTOR fan. I'll be completely upfront about that, because I couldn't stand how you'd see games like Ape Escape coming back. You'd see these random titles getting remakes, re-releases, and I'm like, why isn't Star Wars re-releasing like literally the best thing to come out of it in the video game universe? One of the best-selling IP for it? I don't know. Crazy to me, but hopefully this is the year they screw their heads on and do the obvious thing. I know backwards compatibility exists, but there are Switch players, PlayStation fans who have yet to experience this. Please give them the opportunity, re-release them. Now, I know this goes without saying, but I want to go ahead and solidify my point. We know that Disney limited a lot of what was canon within the expanded universe for Star Wars, really picking and choosing there, and there were certain exceptions. Like, I remember the Old Republic MMO was sort of okay in certain aspects, and I can't speak for everyone else, but I personally feel like when it comes to books, comics, movies, shows, games, I have a tougher time getting invested when I feel like that story isn't actually counting. It's not being added to the overall vision of Star Wars. And that's not to say that comic 5 of some random Star Wars series has to count towards the rise of Skywalker. It has to be considered. No, don't get me wrong there. But it's important to have your entertainment include some sort of weight, I would say. And seeing Revan be inducted back into the canon is, of course, that necessary first step into bringing back the Old Republic. We've seen nods, little things hinting at the lore, but to see Revan's name there on paper, there was a Sith Trooper unit named after him, a ancient Sith Lord. They are accounting for a lot of things that did build up Revan in the past. Of course, there's Malachor, there's the Jedi Crusaders. So there is a little bit of a story building around Revan, respecting a lot of what we already knew, which is good because we don't really want a lot of that to change. Ultimately, I can sort of see Disney deciding, you know what? let's put our own stamp on the Old Republic, of course doing their own film, but when it comes to the games, Disney doesn't have a heavy amount of involvement, so that's also worth considering that. I would personally say, yeah, they're gonna just go ahead and reboot the series, but Disney said their hands are sort of off the games, so it's up to EA if they want to reboot it, and I don't think that's a part of their plan, so more than likely, we do get a re-release of 1 and 2. But anyway, I think it's finally happening. I wanted to put this all together in a video. You guys know me. I covered the remake mod that was in the works for a while before Disney shut that down. I've covered everything Knights of the Old Republic related for years. You know, this is more to me than what Fallout 4 was, quite honestly. Like, I'd covered that for years, and I wanted it to happen, and I was super hyped when it did happen, but this means more to me than that. So just weigh that out. I seriously cannot wait, and I would have gotten to this a little bit earlier, but I was on my vacation. I wanted to respect my vacation to properly recharge so I could have good energy for you guys in these types of videos. So I apologize that the news is a little bit old at this point, but still, you guys know me, gotta cover all my bases. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, I'd love to hear from you. Do you think we're getting a little Revan this year? Fire away in the comments down below. Other than that, follow me on Twitter, follow me on Instagram. Those links are in the description down below. Big thank you to the patrons for being the Knights of Revan and joining me in this battle. I do appreciate all of you. And thank you to everybody who did support me and watch all the way through. I appreciate you giving me your time today. Other than that, be sure to consider supporting my Patreon as it fuels all the content I create here. Stay sexy, stay active. I love you all. Peace.